Here we are at I-75 Speedway. They had an open practice tonight, September 1st, Labor Day. We're here with Steve Owens, Jr., number 17. Ran Thunder and Lightning at 411. You want to run street stocks here?
A hobby if they're going to have it, or maybe sportsman's if they don't have the A hobby class.
Well, you've been out there several times today. It's a brand new configured track. What'd you think?
It's a pretty neat little track. I'm not really used to flat tracks. I've only ran on one other one, and it was in a late model. But as far as this car, it actually likes this track a little better than the bank track for some reason.
Well, I know they're going to be opening September 13th of 2014 this year. That's 2 weeks from today as practice. Were you going to be here?
We're going to try and make it. Just see what how the funds work out and stuff for fuel. But we're going to try and make it down here as soon as possible.
Well, talking about funds, let's go ahead and give your sponsors a shout-out so maybe they can come up with some funds for you to be promoting them.
All right, everybody that makes this possible is Mike Hall at Hall & Ass Racing, Junior Garrett's Roofing, and Rusty Radiator on Ford Hill on Seymour, Tennessee on Chapman Highway.
And that was Hall & Ass Racing, folks. Here we are with Justin Tabor. He drives a number 25 limited late model, or you have run a crate?
Limited late model.
All right. Well, now you're down here at I-75, also on practice night. You're a regular at Crossville. What'd you think of the I-75?
Man, I love it. It's just nice to be able to get away from Crossville for a little bit and come down and experience a new track. Been waiting for this place to open all season, and I'm pretty satisfied with it. Love it.
Yeah, unfortunately, due to the weather we've been having in East Tennessee, I think they wanted to open in July, but now their opening is going to be September 13th. And you're running for points at Crossville, correct?
Yeah, I was. I was second, I think, maybe third. And then I took about a month and a half off, tried to get the car figured out, and I think we're about down to fifth or sixth maybe right now.
Well, I don't want to make Crossville mad at you, but do you think you'll be down here on September 13th?
Probably be here from now on, be honest with you.
Closer to home?
Well, no, I live in Crossville. I just, it's just nothing against Crossville, but I mean, it's just, seems like a better track for the car. I have a little more fun here, and you ain't competing with money.
Well, that makes sense, too. I know you got some sponsors here. Let's go ahead and give them a shout out.
I'd like to thank Mountain Valley Packers, Volunteer Tree and Landscaping. Yeah, Prograde Construction. These guys, they help me out a lot. I mean, well, Tony helps me out a lot. He does all of our motors and makes sure we can get around the track.
Well, now, you said this was your first year in racing. How's it been for you? How did you get into racing? Let's put it that way.
My grandpa, he raced for years. Venable Tabor, he raced the number 25, and that's where I got my number. I was always with him all the time. I mean, since the time I was born, I got in it and finally could afford to start doing it, and didn't think I'd be doing as good as I am, but I still got a long ways to go. Need some more seat time.
Are you having fun?
Oh, I'm having a blast. Love it.
Well, thank you for taking your time, and thank you, Angie and Tim Kyle. I'm sure they appreciate you coming down for practice today, and hope to see you back.
Oh, all right. I'll be here.
Here we are with James Kelso, otherwise known as Scooby-Doo, and he drives number 49 late model at Smoky Mountain, and he come down here to I-75 tonight to practice. Well, what'd you think?
I loved it. I mean, it took a little while to get the setup different from Smoky Mountain, you know, long track, you know, long sweeping curves. So this tight little bull ring, this is really going to be a place that's going to put up some action.
Well, now we know you run Smoky every time they're open. They're opening on September 13th. Can Tim and Angie expect to see you here?
We're hoping so. We're kind of racing on a real thin budget this year, and we've kind of dedicated ourselves to Smoky Mountain. But it's looking like everything's lining up, and the old star, as they say, the stars are coming together, and it's looking like we'll be down here for the 13th on our opening night. So.
Well, I know you carry a good fan base with you. We all love you. You're a nut. So we're hoping you can make it down here, or whenever you get to race at Smoky, we'll cheer you on there. You got some sponsors you want to mention?
Yeah, I'd like to thank MK Russell and Abbott Heating and Air. You know, if you need your heat and air done, well, they're the folks to get. We got JT Kerr Racing Equipment, and which has kind of fizzled out over the years, but they're still supporting us in a huge way. And East Tennessee Fence Company, you know, they've been with us for a really, really long time, and they help us out tremendously. And O'Reilly Auto Parts, you know, old Jackie out there in Eagleton, he helps us out a lot.
Now, I forgot to ask you, do you run a crate or do you run a limited?
It's a limited motor.
It's a limited motor. All right. I guess, well, I just appreciate you coming out. I'm sure Tim and Angie do too, coming out here. I mean, what did you think of the banking?
The banking is a little get used to. I've never run a flat track before. This is my first one, relatively flat. You know, I've always had Smoky Mountain, Atomic, or Tazewell, so, or North Georgia. So this tight little flat bull ring is going to be something that me personally is going to have to take a lot to get used to. But I think I can get it down. It might take, you know, 5 or 6 years. But I might get it. So, you know, we should be doing all right. You know, we worked on a car a lot today. We went out probably at least almost a dozen times and, you know, made drastic changes early to get a ballpark where we needed gear, spring, shocks, and all that kind of the good stuff. And then after that, we kind of fine-tuned it in and kind of got the roll center a little better on the car to get our entry a little better. And I think we did okay by the end of the night. So I think when 13th rolls around, I think we'll be good to go down here, you know, be able to put on a good show for them.
Well, y'all heard him. He's going to try to be here on the 13th. Come on down to I-75 Speedway and root on Scooby-Doo. Thanks, boss. All right, here we are with Marcus Thompson, driver of the number 10 Mini Stocker. Got you a little Toyota here, huh?
Yes, sir, I do.
Well, now, last night, I know you've run 411. Mm-hmm. You started running Wartburg. What happened last night?
Well, the old little Toyota motor paid off. It was slick in the heat race, and we was able to put the power to the ground real good and end up winning last night. So it was my first win. I feel good, you know. It definitely always gives you confidence when you get a win. So hopefully we can continue that.
Well, now I was talking to your crew chief over here. He won't be on video, so he ran off and hide. He must be wanted in another state. He said you used to run motorcycles. And you're a daredevil on those things.
Yeah, I've actually raced amateur pro for about 5 years now. And I had a knee injury, and I got a little girl now, and I mean, racing's in my blood, so I had to do something, and this is just a lot of fun. You don't get as much out of the car racing as you do the motorcycles, for sure, but yeah, it's just totally different. I mean, it's always good to change it all up eventually, you know.
Well, now you come out here and you practiced at I-75 Speedway, mm-hmm. And what'd you think of this place compared to the 411 and Wartburg where you've been running?
Well, you know, I enjoyed going over to 411 and racing the track there. It's, you know, you do a lot of passing in the turn at 411, which I like that. Wartburg, it just how it ends up. It's one of the craziest tracks as far as changing. So it's interesting to go over there. It keeps you on your toes on your setups. But this track is going to be, it's all about the man behind the wheel here. You know, you take it in good and hard and drive it through, you'll have a lot of fun. But it's a different, I mean, it's kind of like I-40, but a lot bigger. It's fun. I mean, I enjoy it. Could be just a tad bit wider. That's about it. Other than that, dirt's really good. A little rough now, but they'll work that out.
Yeah, it was the first practice. That's to be expected. Of course, we did run it in the daylight. They opened today at 5, or practice started at 5, they opened at 3. So for about 3 hours, y'all were out there in the sun. And now you're saying that there was moisture coming back up?
The moisture is coming back up. I mean, the track changed tremendously. That's why I waited it out so long, because I wanted to see what it done when the lights, you know, come on and you start getting that dew from the ground. And it's definitely showing. And the big thing about this track, is that there's two corners out there, and there's two different ways. It's two different kinds of dirt. You got a dry slick on one side, and then you got a tacky side. So, I mean, there again, it's going to be fun to drive. You know, it's going to be hard to be consistent for 15 laps.
All right. Well, do you got some sponsors you want to thank?
Definitely want to thank Amsoil, Dave Groves. He helps with this car. My papa, John Housley, my uncle, Larry Housley. We've been, you know, my papa's helped me out quite a bit. My uncle helps me out on driving. So, you know, we got a good thing going right now, and hopefully we can get a lot more wins.
Well, we wish you the best luck for the rest of the 2014 season. I know they're going to be here opening on the 13th. Do you think you'll be here that night?
Oh, yeah, I'll be here.
All right, there's another one Angie and Tim Kyle can count on being here. Well, we appreciate you taking the time. We appreciate Tim and Angie inviting us out here to do this for them. And we appreciate these guys coming out. And the fan count today was awesome.
Unreal. I mean, I'm just absolutely super pumped about how many people showed up to here to support it. You know, a lot of people don't understand. I hear people complaining about money and stuff, and it's a hobby. I mean, it's going to cost money. And these people that are putting these events on, it's time consuming, and it's a lot of work. You think you work on a car a lot, you got to come out here and work on this track just as much. So, you know, anytime we can get new tracks, I'm super excited about it. And I mean, I'm always going to be there to a new track, because I want to racing, period, any kind of racing.
Well, we got to support our local tracks, whether it's a dirt track, an asphalt track, whether it's here, Crossville, Wartburg, 411 Motor Speedway, Tazewell. Get off your butts, go to a racetrack. Yep. If you don't go, the gates close.
Yep.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
You got me. All right, here we are at I-75 Speedway here in Sweetwater, Tennessee. Y'all had your first practice today. Heck of a turnout.
Yeah, it sure was, Flipper. It was a very, very good day. Had a great crowd, 73-plus cars here with us today. Just a great deal. We want to thank Tim and Angie Kyle for putting this deal together with us, giving I-75, the old Murphy Speedway, a new chance, a new life. It was a good deal.
I just want to confirm opening date.
We're going to open Saturday, September the 13th. Gates open at 5. We'll probably hot lap around 7 o'clock. We're going to have another practice next Saturday night. Gates open at 5 and 7. We'll get started. So looking for finish out the year on a bang.
Okay. Well, now, classes. How many classes are you going to run? Which classes are they going to be?
We're going to have we'll have late model steelheads, crates, hobby cars, Thunder and Lightning, Four Bangers, and the
Mod Lights
will be with us every other weekend. And then we're going to try to throw in a couple of special events before the year's up with super late models.
That sounds exciting. And we can go to, what is the website?
WWI75 Speedway. And we're on Twitter, we're on Facebook. You can call Angie or myself, either one, and we'll be glad to help anybody with any directions, any rules, anything they need to know about.
Right. I'm going to put it right here, www.speedwayvideos.net or .com. I don't know what it is. It'll be right here. See, it's right here. Appreciate you, Monty.
Right, thank y'all. We appreciate y'all coming down and being with us.
Excellent. We had a great time. Awesome to see this place back open. Love the new configuration. Fans, drivers, all seem to love it. We interviewed several drivers. They've all committed to be here on the 13th, so we're going to have a hell of a show here, folks.
Yeah, we look for a big opening night. Angie's put a lot of special deals together for kids and stuff like that, so we look for a big night come September the 13th. We've got a few more things we've got in store to finish up on, and, you know, we're going to work towards making this the best place to race in Tennessee.
Well, we look forward to seeing it happen. Thank you, Monty.
Thank you.